Hey there, Kacey here. What we've got today is a Tesla software update. Why I'm in the garage rather than in the car or in the office is on social media there was a micro clip of a Tesla port facility where some folks saw the flashing lights from what I think is the four-way flashers and assumed that that meant that the cars were undergoing a massive software update together. While it is possible, it is extremely unlikely from my experience with people moving mass amounts of cars. I used to work at several dealerships and car rental facilities where we would move 300-400 cars at a time, and some folks turn on the flashers. So what I've done here, pardon the mess in the garage, I was supposed to clean it a little while ago, but moving in, we just haven't finished that yet. So over here, my awesome little rig here. I've got my my GoPro and Luna's GoPro hooked up to do a recording of the car, and we're going to look and see if the lights flash at all. Now, I've sat through numerous software updates in both this car and several other Teslas, including our last one, and several owned by Tesla, several owned by friends, and the most we've ever seen is a flash of the headlights occasionally. So I'm gonna set these GoPros up. Well, they're already set up. I'm gonna turn them on and have them record for the duration. They're gonna record for the duration, and then up here, you can see both the short clip and the full length clip, so you can look for yourself to see if the four-way flashers flash at all. My GoPro is set up so that it can see the whole rear of the car, minus the cut for the window, and hers is looking at the passenger side rear. It's actually looking at the taillight itself, but I did check with the lights off that it can see the four-way flashers. So then after that update finishes, what we'll do is we'll go through and for sure we'll do a deep dive, but depending on what is listed in the patch notes, we will see the release notes. We'll see what is in there, and if it's something cool, we'll look at it right away and do a quick look. If it's not, we'll do a deep dive where we go through all of our tests and see what's in there. So what we're about to do is we're going to kick it off from the phone. Before we do that, we're going to turn on the cameras. And then we're going to make a loud noise so that they can be time synced. All right, so now that we've made our loud noise, we're going to kick off the software update in the phone. I've showed you guys how to do this before. We're going to click on software update at the top. We're going to update to 2021. .4.2. So this is our first 2021 series update. Yes, we're finally out of 2020. And let's go ahead and click software update. Install now, question mark, 25 minutes, blah, blah, blah. We'll see if it actually takes 25 minutes because we've got the cameras now. But typically, I get an alert like an hour later, like 50 minutes or so, saying that the car has completed. So we click install. Software update starting in 1 minute and 55 seconds. All right, take it away, GoPros. What we're gonna do is we're going to turn off the lights, that way they can see the car, and we'll be back after the update, and depending on what video you're looking at, we'll get in with the good stuff, or we'll get in with the debunking. We'll catch you on the flip side. Well, well, well. Here we are with software update 2021.4.2. Minor fixes. I like this new interface for it, but yeah. So what that means is that we are now going to go into a deep dive video for this because minor fixes is a really short, quick look video. Let's take a look and see about our software update. Complete as of February 9. Navigation data is still 2020.48. So catch you on the flip side. I want to thank our patrons and our channel members. Over here are some videos that YouTube thinks you'll enjoy. And down here is a subscription bubble. We'll catch you on the flip side.